So hello friends, welcome to my channel Jobonymous, and in today's video I'm going to discuss with you aptitude test questions in section numerical ability for TCS NQT, TCS Smart Hiring and Amazon. Today I'll be covering some very tricky questions that have been asked for the test in these companies, but actually if you know the trick to solve them, these questions are actually very easy. So I'm going to show you those tricks, and with this help you'll be able to solve them and gain competitive edge over your competitors. So let's start today's video, but before that, just a request to please like my videos to support my channel. So regarding the aptitude test, TCS or Amazon or even any other company, it consists of numerical reasoning or quant or maths as one section. Second is logical reasoning. Third is verbal reasoning. So today I'm going to be covering tricky questions in numerical reasoning part. So let's start with the first question, which is, what is the average of all natural numbers between 25 to 91? So if you look at this question, this seems to be a very tricky and tedious question, because you will have to, you know, calculate the sum of all numbers from 25 to 91 and then divide it by total numbers between 25 and 91, which is a huge process, time taking process. But if you know the trick, which is just the formula to solve this question, you will be able to solve it. So the correct answer here is 58. So here you have to do nothing, you have to just find the average of first and last number. So 25 plus 91 divided by 2. So 116 divided by 2 equal to 58. That will be your answer. So if you get any question like this, you can just find the average of first and last number. That's it. And you'll be able to solve it. You don't have to make tedious calculation. Next, what is the product of roots of x from the following equation? So this equation has been given, and you have to calculate product of roots of x. So what many people do is they start solving this equation and find the value of x, which is not at all required, because again here there is one formula that you can easily apply. So the product of roots of x in a quadratic equation is this number divided by this number, so it is 8/5. It is as simple as that. And if they tell you to find the sum of roots of x, then it is minus b/a. So it then the answer would have been 3/5, but in this case it is product of roots, so it is c/a, because you can write this equation as ax square minus bx plus c. So this number divided by this number is the answer. How many times hands of a clock coincide in a day? So again, this is a bit tricky question, because most of the people think that in a particular day there are 24 hours, so every 1 hour hands of a clock coincide. So in one day it will coincide by 24 times. However, this is not the answer, because the hands of a clock coincide every 65.45 minutes. So this is the answer. So in one day there will be 24 into 60 minutes, 24 hours, and 1 hour has 60 minutes, so 24 into 60 divided by 65.45, so it will come out as 22. So this is the answer. You can just remember this, that it coincides every 65.45 minutes. So even if they tell you how many times it will coincide in 12 hours, so you can just replace 24 by 12 and the answer you will get is 11. So this is how you can easily solve this question without applying any equation. In how many ways can the letter of the word position be arranged? So this is a question from permutations and combinations. So again here you can apply a simple formula, which is the total number of letters in this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 factorial divided by the number of letters that are similar. So 1, 2, these two are similar and I and I are similar, so 2 factorial into 2 factorial. So whatever similar letters you will get, you will have to divide by their factorial, then you will get the actual answer. So it is 8 factorial total letters divided by the number of repeating letters, which is 2O and 2I, so 2 factorial by 2 factorial. So in case you don't know, factorial is pretty simple. 1 factorial is 1, 2 factorial is 2 into 1, 3 factorial is 3 into 2 into 1. So whatever factorial is given to you, you have to multiply it with previous numbers. So 4 factorial will be 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So this is how factorial is calculated. So again, a question that is based on factorial. 1 factorial plus 2 factorial plus 3 factorial plus 4 factorial up to 100 factorial divided by 7. So what is the remainder of this? So many candidates, you know, just completely leave this question and run away because it seems to be a very difficult question. It is very difficult to calculate the sum of factorials from 1 to 100 and divide by 7. But again, if you know that proper trick to solve it, you will be able to solve it within a matter of seconds. So here the trick is that after 7, from 7 factorial onwards, all the factorials will be divisible by 7 because all of them will contain 7. 7 factorial is 7 into 6 something. 8 factorial is 8 into 7. So all will have the term 7 and it will be divisible by 7. So remainder will be 0. So from 7 to 100 factorial, you don't have to even calculate because remainder will be 0. So all you need to do is calculate the remainder of the sum of 1 plus 2 plus 3 factorial, 4, 5, 6 up to 6 factorial and divide it by 7. So 1 factorial is 1, 2 factorial 2, 3 factorial 6, 4 factorial 24, 5 factorial 120, 6 factorial 720 and just divide it by 7. So 873 divided by 7. So when you divide it, you will get remainder as 5. So this is how you can solve this very tricky question in a matter of just seconds. So friends, out of these 5 questions, I would like to know how many did you already know. So please do share in the comments box how many questions you were already aware of and how many not. So I just want to gather this information. So this was all about this video. So I hope it would have been really useful for you. So please do like this video and support my channel and subscribe to it to get more such videos in future. And I'll meet you in the next video. Till then, bye-bye.